Hi Sagittarius, welcome to my channel. My name is Chelsea. Thank you so much for liking and subscribing. I really appreciate your love and support. In this reading, we are going to get you some important love messages that you need to hear today. And please bear in mind that this is a general reading and it may not resonate with each and every one of you. Spirits and angels, please show me important love messages for Sagittarius today. Please bear in mind that roles can be reversed between you and the person whom you could be thinking about or dealing with. For those of you, Sag, if you're in a connection, a relationship or a connection, love connection that is full of drama with the Five of Wands here, there's somebody here with the Five of Cups and the Knight of Swords in reverse regretting over what they have said. It could be you or this person. Again, roles can be switched. But there are some regrets here in regards to something that this person has said to you or what you've said to this person. Because obviously, Five of Wands can indicate some sort of an argument or drama. But such, there is also, for those of you, you know, because Five of Cups here also feels like someone could be disappointed or feeling sad. Because somebody is not talking, it could indicate that as well. Knight of Swords. Those of you, if you're not speaking with your person right now, or your person has decided not to speak to you, either or, the Five of Wands can indicate somebody feeling really conflicted, right? Whether they should talk or not, or someone could just be really disappointed because this person is not telling them the truth or not communicating. Okay. I feel like some of you, if this person is not communicating to you, or if you're not communicating to this person, that's because there's an indecision with the Five of Wands. So I'm feeling really conflicted over whether I should communicate or not. But the first storyline, again, the Five of Wands can indicate some sort of drama arguments. I feel like there are definitely regrets in regards to something somebody has said here. When I say somebody or someone, that means it could be you or this person. Queen of Wands here in reverse, Eight of Swords, and also we've got the Ace of Wands. Someone is thinking like, well, is this person, will this person still like me? Will this person still be attracted to me because, you know, I didn't say something or because I've said something that was either rude, aggressive, or, you know, or someone may have caused some arguments here, right? But so there are a lot of thoughts here, Eight of Swords. Some of it could be you or this person just thinking a lot and feeling really stuck. Also, it can indicate someone wondering if they should reignite this passion, because the Justice indicates a very important decision, right? I do see somebody could be in the midst of making a very important decision. And the decision, Justice, you know, can indicate either what if one should take this connection to the next level, making it official, or, you know, I don't know. I just feel like, again, there are a lot of indecisions here. Someone's conflicted. Can I do it? Can I take this relationship to the next level? Or will this person take this connection to the next level? And the Queen of Wands here is in reverse, Sag. This could be you. This could be the other person, but it's a fire energy and it can be any sign. I mean, it doesn't really matter. It can be any sign, okay? Sagittarius, Aries, Leo, some of you could be dealing with also a fire sign. Could be a Libra, Gemini, Aquarius. Again, can be any sign. But Seven of Wands here in reverse indicates somebody feeling like maybe I should end the fight, give up on the fight, or give up or end the drama here. But also somebody could be trying to end something by not taking any actions, right? Or unsure whether they should take any actions towards you or you towards them. We've got the Knight of Swords and the Justice here. So I feel like such, whether it's you or this person, somebody will take actions eventually and make things right, because the justice has a weighing scale here, right? Just to, I would say, make things right, make things fair. Someone will either try to be fair to you. Trying to be fair to you by letting you know what they've been thinking about with Eight of Swords here. It feels like this person has been thinking a lot about you, or you could be thinking a lot about this person. But the Nine of Cups, Four of Cups, and the Lovers in reverse, again, it indicates a choice here. For those of you, Sag, if you're involved in a third-party situation, the Queen of Wands can indicate that right here. If you're involved in a third-party situation, somebody's going to make a choice, whether it's you or this person. And I feel like this choice is the Nine of Cups here. You know what? I'll be better off alone. I don't want to be a part of this equation. You may end up turning your back on somebody because either it's way too competitive, or that there could be other people involved, third party. Four of Cups, you know, not accepting this arrangement, or not accepting this equation of being an option, or being in a third party situation, because the Lovers here is in reverse, so somebody's gonna make a choice that is right for them. And such, I feel like for a lot of you, it could be you making a choice for yourself that is right for you when it comes to love, or it could be somebody making a choice, your person, making a choice that they think is right for them. Because Nine of Cups can indicate, you know, I need to think for myself, I need to be selfish this time around, right? Let's see more. So there's some suspicion here for some of you, Page of Swords in reverse. If you're dealing with someone, or someone does, if someone doesn't trust you, okay, or you don't trust somebody, because the Six of Wands can indicate someone very attractive. So there's someone here really, really attractive and may have a lot of options. I feel like then the other person may feel a little bit insecure in regards of how good looking this person is, or how charming this person is, or how popular this person is, and really would like to find out some secrets. The High Priestess here in reverse. Someone may be suspicious of you entertaining other people, or you could be suspicious about somebody for entertaining other people. It could indicate insecurities, because the High Priestess in reverse can indicate paranoia as well. Some of you, I feel like this person could be paranoid about you because you may be really good looking or very popular, or you could be very paranoid about somebody because you're very good looking or popular. Again, it could go vice versa here. But definitely there is a stuck energy with Eight of Swords here. Somebody is stuck thinking about taking actions, thinking about taking the relationship to the next level here. But unsure if it could be successful, because the Six of Wands indicates success as well. So someone could be looking into the situation, looking into, or, you know, trying to find some information, or thinking about details, the smallest thing ever. Overthinking, right? Someone could be overthinking about you, about the outcome of this connection, or you could be overthinking about someone and the outcome of this connection. Again, the High Priestess in reverse and the Lovers in reverse indicates some sort of paranoia, and someone just might sabotage this connection because of paranoia. Yeah, I definitely get this message here, but let's see a little bit more. The Tower here is in reverse, the Empress in reverse, and the Four of Wands. Feels like on one hand, someone thinks that, you know, I really want to make things official. Making things official could be getting married, or just being in a committed relationship, deciding to be in a committed relationship. But on the other hand, it's like the Tower here in reverse. I'm afraid that my world is going to fall apart if this person ends up leaving me. I keep sensing like someone is feeling really insecure because the other person is very successful or is popular or is very good looking, charming and popular and all of that good stuff. Yeah, because the Page of Swords in reverse is like almost like a stalking energy, and the High Priestess in reverse is paranoia. So somebody could be stalking you, spying on you because they're so paranoid about you. But actually, this person wants to be in a relationship with you. Or maybe because this person wants to be in a relationship with you, but they're unsure if it's going to be successful, right? I see a bit of a paranoia. Because of somebody's paranoia, he or she's going to sabotage this connection. Else, it could have been a good thing because the Justice and the Four Wands here. Yeah, that's actually the main message I'm getting here, Sag. Or it could be you feeling paranoid about somebody, and, you know, again, it could go vice versa here. Because the Tower here is in reverse, so this connection could be destroyed because of somebody being paranoid, overthinking, overanalyzing, afraid they'll get hurt, feeling rejected. Feeling rejected, I wouldn't say for no reason, but feeling rejected because because maybe the other person is better looking or more popular, alright? This is your reading, Sag. Hope you resonated in some way, shape, or form. If you did, please hit like, share, and subscribe. I'm going to leave you with two playlists on the screen right now. The first one is from my second channel. It's a travel vlog channel. Check it out if you want to. And the second playlist is from this channel. It has all of the readings that I've done for you and for the rest of the signs with different topics and different questions. But these readings are still new because I post them every single day, so it's still relevant, okay? Hope to see you back here again tomorrow. Take care, Sag. Bye.